Last time on The Idol Effect, Bill and Ted escaped the clutches of the evil whack job 7 of 9. Let's join them now as they embark on a brand new adventure.
Hey Ted, what's that over there?
I don't know, let's go look.
Cool. Super Mini Action Pulse, 531 Mini Action Pulse. Welcome in, The Idol Effect. Number 5, episode number 5 is in Johnny 5. Is alive on Babylon 5. I don't know what that means.
These are the voyages of Babylon 5.
No one liked that show. I liked that show, but no one else did. I'm Jer White. He's Charles Walter Ellis Esquire.
The third,
which means there were two other fucks before him, which is just
You'd think they would have stopped.
You'd think.
So.
No common sense. So. Let's see. Let's just jump right in.
You reckon?
What are you playing?
I've been waiting for you to ask. That's the Wonder Woman theme song, the new Wonder Woman theme song.
Oh, yeah, that was damn loud.
So, which is a good, basically brings us right into.
Well, no, not necessarily.
Okay. Maybe it does. Maybe it doesn't.
Okay. Now we could do the obvious thing, and we could jump into a Batman Superman review. We could do that.
Right. Yeah.
Or, no, stay with me here. Last week, I had my mom's cesspool pumped out. We can talk about that.
Mm.
So, take a moment.
Mm.
Bat soup or shit soup, I guess, are your choices.
Wow. Yeah. Let's still go with the... let's still go with Batman Superman.
All right, but you know what you're missing.
I think that's what everybody's wanting to hear.
But, you know, cesspool.
Yeah.
Couldn't cesspool be like Deadpool's like younger brother? Cesspool couldn't.
Makes sense.
His special power would be like he takes shit from others.
Right.
He takes everybody else's shit. That's his superpower.
Hence the name.
Seth. Anyway.
Thank I like you very it. Much.
I may or may not be here all week. I don't know. I'm gonna let you start.
Bat soup.
Go ahead.
Yeah, okay. So Batman Superman
Bat
came
soup,
out.
Bat soup. The cup right there. And I paid extra for that.
And as if you haven't seen it, there's gonna be spoilers here because we don't have that discipline to have the spoilers and then the non-spoiler
review.
If
you haven't seen it, then you're listening to the wrong show anyway.
You're definitely one of few. You most likely didn't like it, I guess, because it's being panned and just drilled into the ground. But
I think I know her.
It's over. It's over 500 million sold.
I think I know her too.
Yeah. I just set them up.
I'm not taking this seriously, am I? Okay.
No. But 500 million in box office so far, but it's really, I mean, taking a beating. For all these people that are seeing it.
I think I hurt him.
No, come on now. So, but, I mean, I don't know where we stand on this yet. I actually hadn't had a chance to even discuss that with you, even though we both saw it.
Yep,
but
we did. Opening night or Thursday night?
It's people are ripping it apart, but it's making 500 million so within its first week. So I'm kind of wondering. I don't know. What did you think? I personally dug it. I thought it's a big dumb comic book movie, but so what? Fucking, it was a spectacle visually. Fucking, what did you think? Let me know where you stand.
1 to 5 stars, I give it a 3.5, but I couldn't dance to it.
Well,
if you want like an American bandstand kind of a thing, then yeah.
Well, how could you not dance to? No, but you know, it's well, 3.5. Yeah, that's about what I would give it. That's yeah.
It you know, it was long.
I think I know him.
Make up your own joke right there. It was long. They tried to cram too much into one movie, but,
right.
You know, there was no way it was going to live up to the hype. There was too much hype.
Yeah, so there was three years of hype, just about.
So you can't bash it for that, because it was never going to happen.
Right. Well, it was done in, I think, 2014. They had it filmed and in the can.
Oh, it was done.
It was done. and then they sat on it for so long, I don't know what... Why? I guess that they couldn't find the right date to open up because this was a good opening date for it because there's nothing really happening until April till Jungle Book comes out as far as blockbusters. So it's gonna make money. It's gonna bring in money.
Is Jungle Book gonna be a huge movie?
I think it's gonna be. It's looking like it is. Yeah.
I don't know Disney stuff, so
But I'm thinking, the way people are ripping it apart, I mean, I thought it was just critics, and I'm like, I'm thinking, hey, look, it's not Blue Jasmine, it's not, you know, No Country for Old Men. What do you critics know? Fuck off. You know, you don't know any comic
book. I never saw either one of those. I never heard of Blue Jasmine.
Blue Jasmine was Woody Allen. The one, it had Dice Man in it.
Woody Allen, no.
So, but, I'm just thinking, but it's comic fans that are tearing it apart. Even Kevin, the man himself, Kevin Smith.
Tell me Kevin bashed it.
Did he bash it? Yeah. He
did a special about it.
On Hollywood Babylon. He ripped it, and I didn't expect it, but yeah, him and Ralph both ripped into it. And I'm thinking, how jaded are we this is a shitty comic book movie? Because it's a fucking, I mean, yeah, it's not perfect.
But Kevin went on a special, a DC special on TV with some other fuckwad that I didn't know, and just was all excited, he'd already seen it.
Well, I think he wasn't allowed to say. I think he wanted to not say. Yeah.
Well, I don't know.
I haven't heard the episode of Fat Man on Batman yet, so I think he's backpedaled a little bit and seen it again, and maybe he likes it a little now, but I haven't heard that yet. I heard him ripping it apart on Hollywood Babylon, and one thing I heard him say was, and I've heard a couple people say this, that the fight could have been avoided with a conversation. So I'm thinking, speaking of Woody Allen...
But who wants to see that?
Maybe Woody Allen should be directing, their comic book movies if they want a conversation between Batman and Superman. Because I mean, I love good dialogue, and I love.
Did you see the conversation between Batman and Superman? That was awesome.
They totally cooled off, and they didn't even go to blows. It was, I mean, a lot of fights could be avoided, with a conversation. I'm sure the Falkland Islands, war could have happened.
Is that considered a war?
I'm sure that Britain's just. Straight up, just...
That's kind of like the War of the Worlds was a war.
Right, right.
Not really.
Yeah, so...
Yeah,
boom, done. But...
I understand why they had to go through the whole backstory of Batman again, which everybody, anybody, even people that aren't comic book people, know the backstory of Batman.
Right.
So, and that was half an hour of my life that I'll never get back.
Well, it wasn't a half hour. It was just the opening credits, really.
No, it seemed like more than that.
It was really just the opening credits, because the credits were opening. It gave you the origin. It seemed like a long time, because it was a long credit opening. But it went, by the time the credits stopped, it went into the Metropolis, the whole 18 months ago in Metropolis, the world is introduced to Superman. And then it went into the Man of Steel segment.
But I get why they had to do that for the Martha tie-in, which is all that whole thing was about.
Martha.
If it isn't for Martha, they don't have to do any of that.
Yeah.
But they needed that. They had to set it up again.
They could have just put the gravestone Martha and had Bruce at the gravestone. But it was just opening credits, I believe.
Or just put up a sign in the beginning and said, both their mom's name is Martha. This will be important later.
It's funny.
Just saved us half an hour.
I don't think anybody ever realized their names were both Martha. Like
I didn't.
I never even thought about that.
It never occurred to me because I didn't care.
But I always called them Ma and Pa Kent. So I knew Thomas and Martha Wayne and Ma and Pa Kent.
Because I never read the Batman's Mom comics.
Did you?
Or Superman's Mom comics. Didn't read one.
The Mom comics? No.
Didn't care.
But one interesting thing is usually Thomas and Martha... are taking Bruce to see Zorro. That's how the story goes. They took him to see Zorro on that night, that fateful night where they were killed. If you notice, this time they took him to see Excalibur.
I'm about to say, I thought I saw Excalibur.
Did you see that? Yeah, okay. Yeah. So Excalibur, which starring, I don't know if you remember.
Excalibur?
Yeah.
No.
Patrick Stewart?
No, really?
Yeah, he was in it. Yeah, a young Patrick Stewart, still bald. But he was... I think it was Guinevere's dad, whatever, yeah.
I did not know that.
I know what I saw! If a boy is chosen, then a boy shall be king! That was his quote. That was his big quote from
the movie. You sold out on that one, too.
Did it? Yeah. Did it? Yeah. And then somebody one night rode up to him and said, are you with us? Are you against us? And he said, against you! So he was on the side of King Arthur.
I felt that one in my nads.
Did you? Yeah.
Yeah. Good. They trembled.
Good. That's
I had trembling nads on
that's what
that
I was
one.
Going for. I was headed right for the nads.
Success.
Right for the nads. Red alert. So,
other than that, once you get past the opening that everybody knows and you actually get into the movie.
You get into the movie.
It was okay. I didn't hate it. Yeah, you know, it was like I said, it was never going to be what we'd all hoped it was going to be. That wasn't going to happen.
No.
So that being said, I didn't walk out of there going fuck.
Yeah, yeah.
It was a good movie. It wasn't great, but it was kind of like, you know, I mean, like Green Lantern wasn't a great movie, but no. It wasn't horrible.
But it was better than Green Lantern.
And it was better than Green Lantern. Yeah, yeah. But I think the point is these comic book fucking haters, what they don't think this shit through.
Mm-hmm.
When they bash this shit, because like Green Lantern, for example,
yeah,
you know, yeah, it wasn't the best movie that ever came down the pike, but if you just would just think about it for a minute and not be a fucking tool, mm-hmm. and just beat the shit out of it, then maybe we get another one,
right? Yeah, yeah.
You know, so what? So this movie's not as good as you thought it was. So yeah, beat the shit out of it. So DC says, well, fuck it, we're not doing it anymore then, because
yeah, yeah, and we would have gotten Sinestro. We probably would have gotten a good Green Lantern movie. And further the universe up further, we might have Green Lantern in the Justice League by now.
I'm not saying, you know, just sign off on everything they do and just kiss their ass just so you can get more movies. Because, like, Fantastic Four, no, fuck you.
Yeah, yeah.
Eat shit and die.
Right, right, yeah.
But if a movie's decent, then, yeah. Eat shit and die and drop bombs.
Right, yeah.
Like Fantastic Four.
Exactly.
That was good timing, man. You nailed that.
Yeah, thank you. But
yeah, don't, you know, just... Okay, so if it wasn't super, no pun intended, then moving on to Suicide Squad, you know, next.
Yeah,
But keep your mouth shut.
Yeah, yeah.
Who cares?
And a lot of people are up in arms because Batman and Superman are both murderers in this. And normally, you know,
if you... Suicide Squad's full of them, so what?
Well, yeah, yeah. Well, I don't think Batman... I mean, I think every movie that Batman... they've done with Batman... since 89, since the Tim Burton Batman, they've murdered. I mean, he killed the Joker. So people are saying, oh, it's not true to the character. Batman doesn't kill. He doesn't use guns. But this is... I think they're going... I mean, you got to accept... I think you're just going to have to accept it. In the DC Cinematic Universe, Superman and Batman are killers. You know, we've established that. You got to get over that. This is more the Frank Miller Batman where he's... You know, he's...
I thought Affleck was all right.
Yeah, I thought he was great. I thought he was really good. I didn't look at him and say, "Oh, that's the guy from Mallrats," or that's. I thought he was a great Batman. I thought him as Batman was great. That guy, Michael Cassidy as Jimmy Olsen, was awesome for the first, you know.
No, I hated him.
Until they shot him. I don't know if you noticed, Jimmy Olsen died in the first, like right up to the credits, within in the desert scene.
Did he?
Yeah.
Yeah, I fell asleep.
So,
no.
And so I think if you were looking for Jimmy Olsen in the DC Cinematic Universe, that was it. So don't blink. But
yeah, how am I gonna sleep tonight?
I don't think he ever even met Superman. Which normally in the comics he's Superman's buddy. You're like, Superman's buddy, Jimmy Olsen.
I can get Jimmy Olsen every week on Supergirl, so I'm good.
Could you? Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. And he's like a big black guy there, so that's even better.
Is he? Oh, okay. So we got Jimmy Olsen.
Little plus white guy.
Yeah, that might be kind of why Zack Snyder killed him off. Because he said that we don't really have room for Jimmy Olsen in this universe, so we thought we'd have fun with it and kill him off. So I found that
kind of dark. Have fun with it?
Yeah, let's have fun with it and blow his head off.
Fucking guy, okay.
Yeah. So, and definitely, Superman killed a guy within the first 5 minutes. He flew that guy through the wall. So I think you just got to accept that they're going to be killers, and that's fine. You know, look at the Avengers; they're all... Captain America's—he's a trained soldier. He's a stone cold killer. He'll pick up a gun and.
It's funny too because, and a really good friend of mine who really knows her stuff, she thought Doomsday was the best part of the whole thing, and I was totally underwhelmed by Doomsday. Didn't really do much for me. But let me preface that by saying, with Doomsday in the comics. Was that like an intelligent character, or was that just a beast?
No, he was just a monster that...
Okay, so they stayed true to the comic.
Yeah, more or less. They created him on Krypton, just kind of like Luthor created him on Earth. And he ended up on Earth. And yeah, he was just a big, dumb lummox.
That really didn't do a lot for me.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
She really liked it. But I think the best part about the whole damn movie was the Batmobile. The Batmobile was
Batmobile was awesome.
Ass.
Yeah, yeah.
I want one.
It was indestructible.
I want one now.
That's another thing. That whole chase with the Batmobile, I thought it was pretty cool. It's pretty awesome. I mean, Batman's killing people left and right. He's shooting a grappling hook in one car and dragging it like a wrecking ball, you know, hitting other cars and stuff. Cool. And, yeah.
My favorite part.
So
my nose itches. Why is my nose itch?
It's... And cocaine! All right!
No scratch off.
You're showing.
Am I?
Yeah.
Nose wiper and scratch off.
Nose wiper. But the Batmobile now looked similar to the Tim Burton universe Batman.
No, I was that shit back.
I was gonna say I have a theory that this might fuck be the you. Tim Burton Joel Schumacher universe Batman.
Tim Burton go fuck himself.
It times out right, like 20 years
I
or
hate
so.
Tim Burton.
So it could very well be that we're watching now. The problem is the Joker in Suicide Squad. So it's either the Joker come back to life or it's a different Joker, but. This is a theory I'm thinking.
What I'm cutting all this out and edit.
You're not happy about that.
Yeah, I'm editing this whole. No, okay. No all Tim right. Burton.
All right. So, all right. Well, what about the Justice League? The cameos.
They were just self-serving establishing shots more than anything else. But you know, whatever. Right. The best thing about them was they didn't take long.
No. Yeah, it was quick. Yeah,
it was in and out.
It was. I think I know her. What was it? Aquaman. He had his
Jason Momoa.
Yeah.
Stargate Atlantis.
Is it?
Stargate Atlantis.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
And he's a friend of mine.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah.
I would have never pictured him as Aquaman.
No.
Earlier down the road, that would have never occurred to me.
Yeah. Yeah.
Whatever.
He was
really
good.
Fuck up Aquaman because Aquaman's boring anyway. So
right.
Maybe he can.
Well, I think he's gonna be
better.
He's gonna be a good Aquaman. He looks badass. Apparently he lives in the Titanic, or hangs out in the Titanic, because that scene was basically...
Well, you might as well.
I mean, if I was down there, I guess that's where I'd go. Where else are you going to go down there?
Nice lens.
Yeah. But hopefully he's not staying in steerage, but that scene was a little bit slow, I noticed. Is that the camera's panning down, and then you see his eyes, and then he's slowly creeping out, and he's like... Hey!
Yeah, and he's kind of like poking at you.
Get out of here! Yeah, he's got his trident, and he's like, and then all of a sudden, bam! You know,
I'll poke you.
It's, I'm gonna get you, man. I'm gonna poke you. But so, and then he bashes the camera and shoots off. You know, so but the Flash had two. They had the one where, well, one thing I noticed is Wonder Woman was looking at that little email that Bruce had sent her. And it's, who are you? And then it's click on these other things. And I noticed Lex Luthor had designed the Justice League.
The icons.
Logos, yeah.
Yeah.
The lightning bolt for Flash and the A for Aquaman. So obviously he's naming Aquaman and the W for Wonder Woman.
That was totally for anybody who...
Right.
In case you are fucking stupid.
In case, yeah, you do.
This is who we're talking about.
That was probably it. Yeah,
that's what that was.
So, and then you also had the scene with Flash coming out of the computer... Or looking like he was coming out of the computer. He's like Bruce Wayne's doing some. He's on the computer. He's doing something, and all of a sudden, from out of nowhere, here comes the Flash, and he's like, "Bruce, Lois is the key." And he's. You don't even really notice he's. I knew I was looking for the Flash, so I was watching for him, because like it's hard to even tell because he's in like a halo suit. He's in like a metal armor thing, but then you see his mask underneath. So looks like he time traveled. Came to Bruce and said, "Hey, Lois is the key."
Yeah, I had to ask you who it was.
Yeah, who's that? I'm the Flash. So I was looking for it. I knew who was playing the Flash, and I was waiting for it. So I knew about that.
I thought he was tripping balls.
He might have been. Well, he wakes up. It's like it's a dream because he's like, "Oh, what?"
He was all home.
Ellis
is Batman.
Hey, Red Man, I think I just saw the Flash, my man.
That'd be a different take on it.
He can bring me some tacos really quick.
I thought that was George Bush. You just went from Batman to Elvis to George Bush.
Yeah, the Flash. Bring some tacos. I don't know. But,
Anyway.
I noticed Lois threw the spear away, the kryptonite spear. She had to go retrieve it later. And I noticed when Superman jumped into the water to get it and she came out of there. Or he came out of there with the spear. It was kind of reminiscent of the first Christopher Reeve Superman movie. Did you notice that? Where he's coming out kind of sick from kryptonite when Gene Hackman had him down in the sewers.
Yes.
He comes out and, you know, and then Miss Tessbacher frees him, takes the...
Yeah, I remember the scene,
It's like, I think that was a nod to that, so. Just without Gene Hackman going, "Miss Tessbacher!"
Which was the best part of those whole movies with Gene Hackman.
Yeah, yeah. Otisburg. Otisburg?
That was the Deliverance dude, right?
Yeah.
Sweet!
And then, Cyborg. Now, I get they have to do Cyborg. I get why they're doing Cyborg.
Well, they have to.
But Cyborg, to me, is going to be a teen titan. Like, he was a teen... You agree, right? Exactly.
My 12-year-old daughter
is sitting here waiting for her segment.
She has a segment coming up in a minute.
So, I understand why they're doing Cyborg, but it would be more exciting if they were doing... I mean, just give us Hal Jordan, Green Lantern, and...
I don't know, because we all hated that, so we're not going there again.
Yeah. So, dumb fuckers. I mean, if they want to be politically correct, I would say give us, like, a Black Lightning would be better than Cyborg as a Justice League member. But that was the paper here, by the way. Not me.
I didn't realize that Wonder Woman kicked so much ass. I guess I was too buried in the Linda Carter thing. But, man, she just kicked ass.
Oh, yeah. She's had centuries of training.
Yeah, that's some serious shit she was doing.
Yeah. So yeah, she was actually Speaking of Wonder Woman, she came out and did you see the smile when I think Doomsday like just basically brushed her off, knocked her to the ground. And she just comes up with a smile and shakes her head and ready to go again, and then gets him with the magic lasso right before Superman comes with right before Superman dies, spoilers,
What?
What? So it was kind of cool because we got to see...
My daughter hasn't seen it yet.
That's the thing, people are... Oh, sorry about that.
Yeah, he's dead.
He's dead and he's not coming back.
I don't believe you.
He's over. Dead, but he's not. Whatever.
But he's going to come back, but...
As Peter Pan.
Yeah. Wendy, come on!
It's a whole different thing.
But you got to see the Trinity. That was cool. As people are ripping this apart, but geez, the action scene, the last hour was all action. You had Superman fighting Batman first, and then Martha! Martha, what? What does that mean? Martha, save Martha! Whole thing happened, and then you had...
That happened.
Yeah. Well, people, either you've seen it or you haven't. It's Martha. And a lot of people are complaining about that being a stupid reason for them to stop fighting. But it's a fucking comic book movie, whatever. He said Martha, he's like, what? It rang a bell with Batman, it touched something, made him stop long enough for Lois to say, hey, it's his mom, it's his mom's name. Fucking chill out,
People take this shit way too seriously. These fucking podcasts that go on and on about these fucking movies.
Fucking podcasts.
You need to lighten up.
So, and we see that Darkseid is coming. Luthor knows that somehow. Lex Luthor knows that. Jesse Eisenberg, by the way, apparently he's Lex Luthor Jr., so if they want to go a different route. If this Lex Luthor didn't work out, remember, he says the line where, my dad was the Lex in front of the corpse. I'm just some crazy guy. Crazy for no reason.
So, he was trying to channel Heath Ledger.
He was trying to be the Riddler or something.
He was trying to get that Heath Ledger Joker, just a little bit of crazy going on.
Yeah. He wanted people to be like, oh my God,
it kind of worked and it kind of didn't. It was okay. But,
I think if he dies now, if he overdoses, then people will remember, oh my God, his Lex Luthor was amazing. You can't top that, so.
Too soon, dude.
Oh, sorry. So, there's going to be maybe no more Clark Kent, but also, not only did Superman die, but Clark Kent died. So, I mean, how do you bring them both back? Obviously, Superman's coming back. Does Clark Kent come back,
too?
Different director, yeah.
Bring everybody back.
Bring everyone, just bring them back with Infinity Gems.
Just like the comic books.
I guess so,
We've done enough. Reboot.
I guess it could be Clark Kent mistakenly didn't die. It was actually some other guy that...
No one dies in sci-fi, comic book, magic, those kind of movies. No one dies.
No one ever dies. Okay.
Not permanently.
Right.
Unless they just their movie doesn't make any money, then they are fucking dead.
Yeah. And then there was a couple cons with it. No pun intended, because our next segment will be discussing the con. But for some reason, Kevin Costner was building a pile of rocks in a dream sequence. Or what seemed in the North Pole.
So. Yeah.
What did Lex Luthor plan to do after Doomsday killed Superman? Like, isn't Doomsday just going to go off and kill everybody in the world?
But I think he had tried to portray himself at that point as one of those guys that just wanted to watch the world burn kind of guy.
So. Right, yeah. So he's got this cush lifestyle. But, you know what? I'm going to kill Superman, Batman, and then let this thing rampage across the world, and I'll probably die too, but... Well, hey. Yeah, okay. All right. Fair enough. And then, okay, the setup. The one thing that bothered me the most part, there was the desert scene in the beginning was supposed to be a setup to make Superman look guilty as if he stormed in and killed mm-hmm. all these people.
Yeah.
So don't they just look at the bullet-riddled bodies of these people and say, well, how many guns does Superman carry? Does he carry guns? No, I don't think he does. Well, this must have been somebody else.
Right, but once again, I didn't even pay attention to that because it doesn't really matter to me how you get from A to B as long as you get from A to B. I mean, yeah, that was kind of ridiculous.
Yeah, yeah. But I agree with what you're saying.
But, you know, it's a comic book movie, you know, what's the line from Mystery Science Theater? You know, just repeat to yourself, it's just a show. I should really just relax.
There we go. So much for the cons. Let's get these out of here.
Moving on.
All right. So speaking of con, we went to Wondercon this past weekend.
Yes, we did.
And Wondercon is It was originally the Northern California version of Comic-Con, and it's reminiscent of Comic-Con in the 90s. Basically, it was about the size Comic-Con was through the early to mid 90s until it started blowing up and getting a little too crazy. So, I don't know. What did you buy? Have a good con?
What did I buy?
Did you buy some good stuff?
I bought the same shit I buy prints.
Thank you very much.
I bought a bunch of prints like I always do with no wall space to put them
up.
Yeah, I don't, something's coming down.
Right, something.
A comic book or two here or there. I was just PR on the show.
PR
mostly.
On the show?
Yeah. putting the idol effect out there for the most part.
At least, one of us had to.
So. Yeah, because it wasn't fucking you.
I had plenty of flyers. I had a whole pocket full.
Pulling your dead fucking weight. You know what? I'm gonna mix this up. Okay. She's been sitting there patiently forever.
Okay.
So I was going to talk about other things first and then bring her in last. But you know what? We're going to switch this. And we're going to go to McKenna's little anime corner.
Right on.
And let her walk around here and tell us about the anime she saw and pretend to care. You ready?
Sure. So this is... Around. McKenna's Anime Minute!
And believe me, we're timing you. You got a minute.
We're
talking to the mic. Either one.
There it is.
Tell us about anime, because we're dying to hear.
Now, the anime you saw at WonderCon, how would you rate that? What did you see, and what did you think?
It started off depressing, because everybody died, and then more people died. Pretty much sums up all of anime, but it wasn't just borderline killing. It had a Batman plot.
Ah.
Like, this is my friend. Oh look, it's dead. Now I need revenge.
That
was kind of like that basic concept of storyline.
So since I'm an anime beginner, or more accurately, I just don't give a shit. But pretending that I did. Explain to me two things. One, why does everyone have the same haircut? Because they do. They all have the same haircut. And two, why is it that people that have like the smallest eyes in the world draw anime characters with the hugest eyes on the planet? Those two things I need to know. And you got 30 seconds.
And,
oh, God.
And why do they always have the same animator that does the anime?
It's not true.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah, it is true.
28, 27.
Big eyes because that's what they wish for. In Japan, they all want.
I've heard that actually makes sense.
Yeah,
that's what they want.
Who doesn't want a haircut thing?
The haircut. Well, it depends. You're talking about boys or girls or both.
Does it matter?
I think they all have.
Yeah, I mean the girls have like giant blue hair, and the boys are just like brown, boringness.
Brown, so there's two haircuts.
Brown. If you're a boy, you're brown boringness. If you're a girl, you have giant pink.
This has been another McKenna's Anime Minute or Corner. What are we calling it?
I don't know. I don't care.
Anime Minute Corner.
Minute Corner.
Corner Minute.
Yes.
Minute Corner.
Whatever that... You got your own theme music, too. I don't have my own theme music.
It's not my fault.
Good job, McKenna.
Thank you, my dear.
How does she rate theme music and I don't get any? I'll get you some theme music happening.
I think I'm feeling...
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Jerry White from the Idol Effect. Oh, mama coming at you, doing it to you.
Stop it. Turn it on.
Okay.
I want my original theme, so... or I want nothing.
Okay, so one thing I noticed, we saw Batman Superman on Thursday night right before the con, because we felt we better see it the first night we can, because we're going to be going to this Wondercon thing, and if we wait till
some fucker will spoil it while we're there.
Some fucking asshole is going to fucking spoil it for some dick.
Like we did to
so we get. So, well, I was going to say, we get there, first 5 minutes, we're putting on our badges. We just got out of line, getting our badges.
Yeah.
You lift up the program. And you're like, should we just X out Superman now since he died in the movie? And the guy next to us who's putting his badge on just gives us his jaw just drops and he looks at us and we're like, oh, sorry, dude. It's like, you've kind of figured, well, you were going to find out no matter what. Since you're here, you might as well find out now. So we were those dicks.
And we did that.
Yeah, yeah. So, but that goes to say there was something, there was a method to our madness. Because we...
Which would be a first.
Right. Because we saw the movie knowing full well somebody would have spoiled it, not realizing the spoilers were us. So.
You are loving your little machine tonight.
Yeah. So, okay. So, the pros. I kind of did the pros and cons of the...
Of course
the
you did. Nope. You love your lists.
Pun intended.
You are a list dude.
The pros. There was 15 to 20 food trucks.
Yeah, that was good.
Which was cool. But
all overpriced.
And I will say this. If you're going to have a food truck, you got to have something to say. I got something that was pretty good. But I think you guys got like something that tasted like a lettuce sandwich or something. Was it your...
Oh, yeah. My wife's sandwich was horrible.
I mean, you weighed in that line. And you think food truck, somebody's got like the movie, I don't know if you saw the movie Chef with...
Oh yeah, good
John
movie.
John Favreau, yeah, yeah.
I was surprised how good that movie was.
He had something to say. It was like, you know, and everybody was just like, oh my God, you know, even the critic that he had a feud with wanted to hire him to be the chef at his restaurant. But yeah, I had something that was decent, but yeah, when your wife said something like, this tastes like lettuce.
There was no meat in it.
Yeah. So,
and she's not down with that.
Right, yeah, no. She likes a lot of meat. So,
thank God.
But having said that, there were plenty to choose from. 15 to 20.
Yeah.
There's some sweet cosplay there. Like,
yeah.
Comic-Con.
That's more your thing than mine, but yeah.
Well, it's cool to see. Cool to look at, you know. There was a Waldo trooper.
A lot more Deadpool this year.
Quite a few. Yeah. I got a picture of a Waldo trooper. It was Waldo, Where's Waldo guy, but he was a stormtrooper.
Yeah.
Basically stormtrooper mask, and took a picture of him in a crowd, put it up on Facebook. Like, nobody got it. Nobody knew what they were supposed to do. I said, where's Waldo trooper? Finally, I had to have my girlfriend, like, circle him in the thing. She was the only one that was able to, you know, nobody figured out that
I... sure nobody got it, or maybe just nobody cared?
Maybe nobody gave a shit.
It could go either
and
way.
And she bailed me out, yeah.
That could very well be possible.
Yeah. The staff at the Comic-Con was mostly cool. They were pretty cool.
Yeah, they're not tools like they are at freaking Comic-Con.
Comic-Con,
you know, get off the carpet or fucking move.
Yeah, move along, fucking, you know. I don't think they realize, just because we fucking read comics doesn't mean we won't fucking choke your ass.
Yeah. And suplex your fucking ass.
Yeah. So, as WonderCon goes, it's not too crowded. So, if you're going to do a con... If you want to go to Comic-Con but you can't get a ticket, that's normal. You probably won't. WonderCon is a good alternative because it is like Comic-Con used to be. It's you can walk freely. You know, it's the price is right. I think it was $40-$50 for all 3 days, and it's not too crowded. I mean, I'm sure Comic-Con, if it could be crowded, they'd let it be. They'd oversell it, but yeah. You know. And
we're gonna keep the attendance level down.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Everyone has plenty of room to walk about. Yeah, sure.
Yeah, yeah. The Microsoft Theater was awesome. That was a nice place. That concession stuff.
A little bit of a hike, but yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Now, well, okay, one thing. Moving, Microsoft Theater was nice. But if Warner Brothers is going to have a panel,
tell us what it fucking is.
Unless it's going to be a big surprise and there's Jason Momoa, there's the Justice League, we're going to show you footage of fucking Wonder Woman. Yeah. Is. Let us know, because, you know, I'm thinking about, I want to get to Warner Brothers tomorrow. Who knows what we'll see? We'll see Wonder Woman. Gal Gadot might be there. You know, we might even hear fucking... But,
I'm counting. That's three.
Yeah. But, it was fun. It was a cool panel. It was a Warner Brothers panel, and with director James Wan, who's actually going to be directing Aquaman, came out. But it was for The Conjuring 2, which looks scary and looks good.
Yeah, yeah.
And then there's some movie called Lights Out, which I guess was a short on YouTube, and it was so good, people called him and said, hey, you want to come to Hollywood and make a movie? Those were both good panels, entertaining, and both of them looked good and scary and everything, but I may or may not have went if I didn't know. You know, I was thinking Warner Brothers, it's got to be DC. It's at Wondercon. It must be a DC comic. They're not telling us what it is.
How come I don't get that call? Come to Hollywood and make a movie.
Well, yeah, I'm sure it's happening now. I will affect the movie. I'm sure it's right around the corner. So, there was no Kevin Smith presence.
He doesn't go to WonderCon.
No,
it's beneath him.
Yeah. But I did find out that Hollywood Babylon, where he bashed Superman, Batman, that was happening that Friday night. Oh, well, so we could have seen that.
And the Lakers were playing right next
the
door.
The Lakers, yeah. So
we were actually going to go to that game that night. We checked out the tickets.
Yeah.
The nosebleed tickets for that game were $200 and some odd a piece.
No.
For a team that's won 14 games all season. Just because Kobe's on his way out the door, they are just raping people. Wong is right.
God. Wow.
He plays 9 minutes and sits on the bench the rest of the time, and you're paying, you know, two bills and change to watch him sit on the bench and go, yay, team.
It's Kobe's farewell tour. So.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. I didn't see Puppy Monkey Baby.
Nope, not a one.
Nobody dressed up as Puppy Monkey Baby. Had I known that was going to happen, I would have been Puppy Monkey Baby. So.
I'd have paid to see that.
Yeah, yeah. How much? I'll do it right now.
Right now?
Well, I need to prepare.
If you do it right now, I've got like $20 I'll give you.
I don't have the stuff. I don't even have a diaper. So maybe next time, next show.
Oh, I bet you have a diaper.
So, but I don't think this convention center is going to house Comic-Con if that's their plan. I don't think it's big enough, because you think if there's that many people that go to Comic-Con in that place, I don't want to go.
No. I don't want to go to Comic-Con in San Diego, much less in L.A.
But you're going, nevertheless. We got to go now.
Because for some reason we got tickets, and now we got to push the show.
Right, right.
So because of those two reasons, yes. But
why do you think I agreed to do the show? Keep you going to Comic-Con. I'm like, let's see, if we do this show, Jerry's going to want to go to the con and push it.
That's evil, dude.
So
yeah, when does that happen? When does that part happen? What's the button for when I spend all the fucking money? What button is that?
That would be.
Yeah, you're damn right. That's my wallet going.
The Yoko Ono button. So okay, so your thoughts. You probably have a few.
Best thing about the con, I thought, was Con Man.
Yeah.
The Con Man panel.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Alan Tudyk. I don't know if that's how you pronounce his name. Alan Tudyk?
Turdyk.
Wash?
Turdyk?
No, it's T-U-D-Y-K. So I think it's Tudyk, but don't
Tudyk.
Quote me on that.
Funny guy. Fucking great guy. Like, that was the most entertaining panel I'd seen in a while. Just because of him. He was good.
You know him from Wash on Firefly and Serenity, and he's done a ton of other stuff too, but that's what you know him from.
Apparently he's in Star Wars.
Yeah, he's going to be in Rogue One. So that's awesome. But, you know, he's... shit, he brought a whole bag full of his own shit.
Yeah.
And everybody who asked a question, he would just sign a piece of his own shit
and
give it to him.
And some of the shit was cool.
Yeah, and some of it was funny, but it was still cool regardless.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, funny guy, seemed like a really good guy. We actually met P.G. Harzma, his executive producer.
Oh, yeah?
For Con Man. We You were standing there, dumb fuck.
Oh, okay, that guy. Oh, the gray guy.
Yes.
Okay.
We actually met him and talked to him. He was cool, and he was actually kind of funny.
Yeah,
he was funny on the panel, too.
He was funny on the panel, and he said he actually might even come on the show.
Yeah. He
might call into the show.
We're going to do a phone interview with him if we ever get off our ass and set that up.
Watch Con Man.
So I actually got on Amazon today and bought season one of Con, because I hadn't seen it yet.
Yeah.
And I watched like the first three. It's funny.
It's a good.
I mean, they're little 10-minute snippet shows, whatever. But
oh, cool,
funny. It's good.
Well, I'm gonna watch it. I'm gonna check it out.
Not unless you pay me. I'm not showing you the shit for free.
Well, I could get my own.
$15. Okay. Amazon.
All right. All right. I'll pay you.
All right. Here. Fuck you then.
There you go.
I'm changing
hands right now.
That was my favorite part of it. Also ran into what is his name? Kaz Anbar.
Uh-huh.
He did the voice for all the Assassin's Creed games,
right.
But now he's doing, he's the, I think he plays Alex, he's the pilot on the show The Expanse on Sci-Fi,
uh-huh. Yeah.
Which is kind of like Sci-Fi's new Battlestar, it's their big budget show,
yeah.
They have one big budget show, and then they have these smaller shows that they don't throw much money at, but his show's got them the Battlestar money.
Right, right.
And they're putting all the and they're coming back for season two. And season one is in the can and it's on demand. And I suggest you go watch it. It's really good.
Is it?
And the ship that they fly in, this is the best part.
Yeah.
Is the Rocinante the Rocinante. Anyway, it's the same ship that Rush sings about in Cygnus X-1.
Oh, really?
Yeah, when they fly into the black hole.
The
Rocinante. It's the same.
So it's a double whammy.
So it's a double whammy for me. My dick's
Rush
hard to sci-fi. Thinking about it.
Oh yeah.
It doesn't get better than that. And he's a real cool dude. So that's always nice when they're cool.
Yeah, yeah.
And just a quick shout out. And I don't remember his name, damn it. And I should have, and that's my fault. Crazy Comics, the booth where they had all the hardcovers and 50% off the cover price.
Oh, right. 50% off cover rights.
Right, and I found
and then they sell fans and fucking bondage masks. I noticed on the.
I don't know what booth you're going to.
Well, they always, those same guys that do those 50% off comics, I think they're thinking some of these guys have girlfriends at home. Not all of them, but some, you know.
Think?
Yeah.
You sure?
Let's do 50% off our books, and then they have these fans, those like Spanish fans that fold out, and those are $5. Then they have these masks that look like, you know, basically something out of Eyes Wide Shut or something like that, you know, something for orgy masks, bondage mask or whatever. Not really bondage, just fancy like sex stuff.
You started to freak me out.
I don't know. I noticed this, and I'm thinking.
I didn't see any of that.
I'm thinking, well, somebody get something for themselves, and then something to take home. Either you go one way or the other. You get the fan, or you get the mask, or you
get the shaft.
Yeah.
Maybe not that order.
Right. Yeah.
But no, I found what was it? A Star Trek Enterprise, or like first generation, you know, Kirk, Spock.
Right.
Up against the Borg. And I thought, well,
that's cool.
That'd be interesting to read.
That's,
so I picked it up, and so I went to go pay for it. And, you know, it was like $4 or $5, not that much. And he's like, you know what, dude, just take it. And he didn't know about the podcast. He didn't know I was anybody or nobody or anybody in between. He just gave it to me and said, So I walked off and I thought, you know what, fuck that. So I went back and said, dude, man,
take my money, motherfucker.
Yeah. Take my fucking money. I'm not no charity case.
Yeah.
No, I went back and told him, I said, hey, man, I'm gonna talk about you on the show because that was a cool thing to do. Yeah. So I just did. So there you go.
Shout out to Crazy
Comics.
Yeah.
Appreciate it, guys.
That's the guy. Oh, that's the guy with the mask and the thing.
No, it was not that guy.
Oh, okay.
Dude, man.
Okay, so...
Are you zipped up? Because if not, zip up, because you're freaking me out.
I'm zipped up.
All right.
Ready to go.
Let's do your...
List time?
Your list, because you are the lover of lists.
Is it Chuck's list time?
Of course you've got music for it. Come on, man.
I like to do a list. What list are we going to do today?
That would be movies that you cannot stop watching. So if you're sitting around at home and you're flipping through channels and you come across this movie, you're in. Whether you want to be or not.
You're in.
You're in.
Well, we've all got those.
And you know who the culprit is? Fucking FX Networks. FX Networks, there are evil fucking bastards that want to suck your soul out of your eye sockets. They play all these movies one after another over and over again because they know that if there's nothing else on, you come through, and there's the Avengers fucking Europe.
Yeah. Boom, yeah, yeah. And not only Avengers, they put Thor, Iron Man, Captain America, then Avengers, so it's like, oh, it's going to be you know what, we're supposed to go up to Oak Glen today? Oh, but look at FX's lineup. Oh, yep. I'm sorry.
Your wife's screaming. Yeah. You're like, sorry, honey.
You're going to have to go without. But yeah, you're right. If all networks were smart, they'd all be FX, I would think. But we all have those movies. I had plenty. The list, I think I said, let's do five movies. We'll each do five. You know, movies that we just can't stop watching if they're on.
And I did 10, and it was, and there's way more than that.
I tried to do 10. I think I may have 12.
Like 30.
Yeah. So, you want me to start?
Oh, by all means. Okay. Go ahead, Ray.
Well, I guess in no particular order, let's go with big one, though, Shawshank Redemption.
Really? Because there was a time, but I think that time has passed.
Really?
Yeah. I can blow past Shawshank if I see it on TV.
You can?
I can keep going. Oh, but anyways, okay. I can see that, yeah.
Still one for me that, you know, pulls me in. Like, you got the...
You know, the warden on Shawshank was... He's the guy that played the starship captain on Next Generation. The captain of the Phoenix that goes after the Cardassian ships.
Is that the same guy?
And that same guy. They have to go get him and shut him down. I forget his name, but anyway.
So he looked like
trick trivia for
looked like he was about to kill himself, but he lived and went on into the future to be a starship captain. So that's great.
There you go.
Was he still running a racket when he was starship captain?
If you considered killing
Kardashians.
I was going to say Kardashians, right, but it's Kardashians. Kardashians would actually be more entertaining to see them kill than Kardashians, but I'll take either one.
Right about now, Jerry is going on to kill some Kardashians. My Morgan Freeman for those.
You need to throw that out there because that was borderline.
So, Roadhouse would definitely be one.
Yeah.
The Double Douche. That one, it's just Patrick Swayze. That one and...
Nobody puts baby in the corner.
Right, yeah. Although he doesn't say that in this movie.
I know, shut up.
He should, but...
Next.
The name is Dalton. Okay, you may not agree with this one, I don't know. Titanic.
Yeah, no.
No?
Yeah.
I get sucked into that thing. I hear fucking, Celine Dion and DeLeon.
There was enough room on that floating fucking piece of wood for both of them. She's a bitch.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's...
And he's a dumbass.
It's been rumored that he actually survived and went on to become the Great Gatsby, and that's really basically Great Gatsby with Leonardo DiCaprio as Titanic 2.
You need to get out more.
So, yeah, she should have, he would have given her his wood. She should have given him.
Really? Yes. Did you actually write that down?
Just now, right off the cuff.
Okay.
So,
I don't believe you, but whatever.
Planes, Trains, and Automobiles?
Yeah.
Those aren't pillows!
Yeah, okay.
That one's fucking... I miss, for that one alone, I miss John Candy. I wish I could see those two in another movie together, so. Swingers.
Yeah, that's on mine, too.
Yeah.
It's like my favorite movie of all time, so I...
Right, yeah, yeah.
That's a given. So, what else you got?
Vegas! Speaking of Vegas, Casino. I get sucked into Casino.
You went Casino? Because I went Goodfellas.
I figured you would.
Yeah, Goodfellas, man. Yeah, I'm in.
Go on. Yeah. Now, this one, I don't even know if you've seen this, but Sideways?
I have not.
Yeah, that one, I can watch that one. It's... It's a road trip movie, which of course I'm a road trip movie whore. We've established that.
You're a whore about many things,
and
but that's one.
Yeah, it's up in wine. It's filmed close to where we live here, up in wine country in Santa Maria and San Luis Obispo.
We're close to where we live.
Yeah, 6 hours, say.
You consider that close? Okay.
And Pulp Fiction, which is...
I was never a big Pulp Fiction guy.
You never cared for that one?
It's okay.
Yeah. I still get, no matter where it's at, what point of the movie, if it's on... I don't... It's not the movie that I seek out in my DVD collection, even though it is there. But it's on enough to where I'll just jump in wherever. Doesn't matter where, you know.
The only movie that Quentin's associated with that I get sucked into, he didn't even direct, he was just in. What would that be?
That would be the one who was in the
come on.
The other guy directed it and he was in it.
Rodriguez directed it, and what was it?
It was fucking Battlefield Earth. No, I don't know. No. I can't think of it.
I'm forgetting the vampire movie with Clooney. What was that called?
Rosemary Clooney?
Yeah, Rosemary Clooney.
What's wrong with you?
Vampire movie with Clooney. Now
George,
I'm even...
George Clooney and he were they were brothers and they were on the run and they went down to Mexico.
Oh, brother, why are you out there?
No.
Shit.
It's a vampire movie.
Love at First Bite.
Okay, we're going to stop because you don't know and I don't remember. Okay. And
well, Pulp Fiction.
It'll come to me later.
Yeah. And the last one on my list, which only I've seen, I've only seen this, I didn't see it when it came out. I seen it within the last year, and since then I've watched it about 10 times. Nacho Libre. You seen that with Jack Black?
You know I haven't.
Oh, come on. Are you kidding me?
No.
So then, yeah, if I quote it, you're not even going to know what I'm talking
about. I wouldn't have a clue.
Well, I tell you what, you got to see Nacho Libre. It's the best.
I don't agree. I don't think I see that at all.
You know what it's about, right? He's basically...
All I know is it's Mexican wrestling, and beyond that, I don't know.
Well, he works at the mission. He's a kind of a... He's a religious guy, but he also wrestles on the weekend.
Lawrence of Arabia. He's an English guy.
He is a religious guy.
They came to fight the Turkish. Yeah. Neat, neat.
And he sees this Mexican wrestler in town, and he's always loved wrestling, but he sees this guy in there. You know, they're adoring him. You know, and he decides he's gonna be a wrestler on the weekends, and he ends up going with it and has minor success, kind of.
And the rest is kismet.
Yeah, it is. So. The taste of the glory. See what it tastes like. You're gonna know what that quote means once you see it. You're gonna love it. You're gonna thank me for it. So
I bet none of those things happen.
That's 10.
Is that 10?
There is one more on my list, but I'm gonna save it. We're gonna do a whole special on it, and I'll just leave it alone. I won't even mention it.
We're not doing a whole special on that.
Well, we're gonna do something with it.
All right. So.
Okay, where's your list?
Right in front of me.
Uh-huh.
Have you noticed, too, that you handle paper way more than I do? All the paper noises you hear, it's all fucking him.
I was probably like
you
an anchor man.
Paper handler guy, yeah.
I was on SportsCenter in my previous life.
No particular order.
Okay.
Gladiator.
Ooh, yeah, yeah.
Come on. Gladiator is awesome.
I dig it.
Last Samurai.
Never seen it.
You fucking kidding me? No. Last Samurai?
I know, it's Tom Cruise, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, dude. First thing you do when you get home.
The show is Wang in it? Like, probably not, huh? Yeah.
But, even if they did, I'd still
You'd
watch
still
it.
Still watch it, yeah.
It's awesome, dude. Okay. Last Samurai is a great movie. The Patriot, back when Mel wasn't a whack job.
Oh, okay.
You never saw Patriot, Mel Gibson?
I probably saw it, but probably once. So maybe if that was one of my movies.
No, once again, that was Heath Ledger was in that.
Was he?
Played his son. Yeah, died there too.
Died.
Yeah, not a good sign. Tom Cruise again. Wow, am I a fudge packer or what? No, Mr. Cruise, you're actually packing fudge. that's South Park.
That's South Park. Right.
Yeah.
Right.
I've got a fudge bagger. He's in the Hershey plant. Mr. Cruise, you're actually
you're putting
chocolate bars in the box. Anyway. War of the Worlds.
Yeah, we got sucked into that one while we were...
Actually, at Con.
At Con. We were watching... Yeah,
we were late to Con because of War of the Worlds.
We had to get...
And that's sad because you know what's going to happen. But it doesn't matter.
But it doesn't matter. Yeah.
Planet of the Apes. And, you know, the latest Planet of the Apes. Not the latest movie, but the latest redo of the...
Mark Wahlberg.
No. Not the Mark Wahlberg. Oh. The one with Freak Show in it. The guy... The movie that you're liking from Dallas, Texas, 63 and all... What's his name?
Oh, James Franco?
The James Franco one.
Oh, okay.
One.
Yeah, yeah. So it's...
That one.
It's something of the Planet of the Apes. So.
No, it's just... Or... Isn't it just Planet of the Apes?
The one with Wahlberg was Planet of the Apes, and this one is like I don't even know why I don't know this. It's you know how they have Escape from Planet of the Apes
or whatever one that was.
Beneath Bride of Planet of the Apes.
Whatever one that was. That one. And you know who doesn't get enough credit is the dude that the dude that wears that suit with all the little balls on it and plays Caesar and does all the facial expressions. That dude get an Academy Award, man. He is awesome in that.
Give an Academy Award to
name? To the dude wearing the Caesar suit. Anyway, Swingers, you know about...
Of course.
Monty Python and the Holy Grail.
Yes, oh yeah, yeah.
Bring out your dad.
For sure. If he died, he wouldn't bother to say, right, it's a great movie. Yeah, I should have put that one here. I was thinking about even watching that today myself.
This one you may not know. I don't... It's not, you know... The Ghost in the Darkness. Have you ever seen The Ghost in the Darkness?
No, I've seen The Devil and Mrs. Jones.
Shut the fuck up. Val Kilmer, Michael, help me out.
Strahan.
No, yeah, Michael Strahan. Sometimes you're just a fucking dick.
Michael Caine?
No, Michael Douglas. I'm sorry.
Okay, yeah.
Mike Douglas, Val Kilmer, they're in Africa, they're hunters.
Mm-hmm.
They're running the railroad through Africa.
Sounds good.
But the lions are killing the workers.
Right.
So they have to bring Douglas in to help them, you know.
Wrangle the lions?
It is so good.
See a lion tamer?
It is so good.
Get that chair and that whip. Get in there! What Ghost in the Darkness? It sounds good. Sounds cool.
It is really
I'll
good.
I'll go see it.
It's not on a lot. But
it,
when it is, man, I'm in.
Yeah.
Goodfellas we talked about. And Spinal Tap. Come on. I gotta have you some tap.
Yeah, yeah. I think I didn't put Spinal Tap on my list because I knew it would be on yours. And
yeah.
And these go to 11. A friend of mine not too long ago went to the... I guess there's a place in somewhere in LA area, Norman's Guitar Shop. And that's where they filmed that scene where he's interviewing Nigel about his guitars, and you know, this one's still got the tag on it.
Right.
Don't even touch that. That was actually in a guitar shop.
Don't even look at it.
Yeah. It was Norman's Guitar Shop. I have a shirt.
That's enough of that one.
Yeah. So but Spinal Tap, actually that might be the movie we should do the special thing we're gonna be doing for the other one that I didn't mention.
You just lost me. What the hell are you talking about?
Okay, well, Can't Buy Me Love is the one I didn't mention. That's the movie I love. Okay. That's one of my favorites. We're going to be doing a special commentary episode.
Maybe.
Bonus episode.
Maybe.
For those, you know, like me who just...
Possibly.
...can't get enough. So, but we should probably do one for Spinal Tap, too.
I might be washing my hair.
You might be washing your hair out of the country that day.
Be unavailable.
Back to school parties lined up, so... So, well, nice. All right, nice.
So that is that.
That is what it is. And
so the other night, we're upstairs laying in bed watching TV, and my wife's heading down and...
Heading downtown.
Yeah.
Mr. Downtown.
Ground round by the pound. And asked if I wanted something to drink. So I said, sure, babe. So she went downstairs and she came back.
Mm-hmm.
I guess we were out of, you know, like... actual real
scotch
drinks.
and fucking,
you know. Something normal. Came back with something called Canada Dry Mandarin Orange Sparkling Seltzer Water. That's like, damn.
Is there more?
I saw orange in the title and figured, right. Okay, that's
gotta,
you know,
be.
I'm good. It's yeah. Got orange in there, right? So I took a big shot of that and I thought I was gonna fucking die.
That good, huh?
It was revolting. It was. So I tried to describe the taste to my wife, and the only way I could ever make her understand just how bad it was,
yeah.
The other day, I was in my mom's house, and I was walking down the hallway, and bless her heart, she has dementia, and so things aren't always on the level.
Right.
And I went to the back room and said, Mom, I'm here. And she goes, oh, come on in. So I walked in, and there she stands, just... buck-ass, full-frontal, 85-year-old nakedness with absolutely no applause from myself or anyone else.
Naked mom.
And so the only way I could explain how bad that Canada Dry Orange tasted was if you could take the visual of my naked mother and make that into a taste... Then that's what Canada Dry Sparkling Mandarin Orange Seltzer Water from Hell tastes like. It tastes like my mom naked.
Totally
so
shaved.
So run out and get yourself a six-pack today, because it's just the best.
Sounds good.
Fucking disgusting. My God.
So totally shaved, right? I imagine.
Dude, what is wrong with you? Wow. But no.
Any other... Did you consume anything else? Recently? Any foods I'd like to talk about?
Thank you, man. Thanks for that, yes. That tethered lead-in right there. Wow.
Yeah, you know.
That was heavy-handed, but I'll take it. A party for my wife's work we went to. I forget where it was. They had like a huge spread, but it was all Persian food.
Mm.
And I don't know if you ever had Persian food.
I don't know if I have.
Yeah.
I might have had some on that food truck at Wondercon. There
was... The majority of it was like unidentifiable.
Right.
It was just pans of goo, and they didn't even have the decency to label the goo, so you knew what kind of goo you were getting. Right, it was just take your best guess as to what the hell. I felt like I was in Meatballs. Remember in Meatballs when they have the announcement, tonight's winner for who, to guess who tonight's dinner was. It was some sort of beef.
Some kind of meat, or yeah.
Yeah, I went out front to see if there was a Chrysler Cordoba parked out front, because I wanted to see if I could win the car for guessing whatever the hell it was I was eating. It was mystery meat for sure. It could be meat, could be cake, you know, meat cake, I don't know.
Isn't that, is it Bill Cosby's line?
No, that's George Carlin's line.
Oh, okay.
If that was Bill Cosby's line, it'd be like, could be date, could be rape. Date rape.
Jesus. God.
Yeah, I know.
Could be Putin, could be Pop, could be Putin Pop.
like the movie, the movie 300, right? Isn't that the movie where that's... like 300 Greeks hold off like 10,000 Persians from...
Yeah. Yeah, well, Zack Snyder, actually.
Really? Okay, I never saw it, but so. That's what the Persians were doing. They were trying to get away from their own
trying
fucking
trying to get away
food.
From their food.
Yeah. Their food's so bad, they were trying to storm in to get Greek food.
To get...
which, from what I understand, is not much better, but...
No, Greek's pretty good, yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Got the gyros and the tabbouleh and the baklava.
I've had enough of that.
Baklava.
That sounds like Klingon.
I think I'm cocky.
Baklava! So
I think I'm choking up one now, so.
Anyway.
So take a nice swig of that nice
that Mandarin orange.
That Mandarin dry orange sparkling seltzer cream soda you got over there.
So here's a couple of examples, or here's one good example of how you know that you're one, married to the right person,
mm-hmm.
and two, been married to that person for a while. This actually happened the other morning. Me and my wife both get up, and she's getting ready for work, and I'm getting ready to take McKenna to school and all that happy stuff. And we're doing our own thing, but at some point we pass each other in the hallway, and she just walks up and goes, meow. And I'm like, meow. And then we just keep going.
Bread and butter.
That was just totally normal for us. Nobody said anything later. Like, what was the catch
about?
It
didn't have to be explained.
Nope.
It was just, meow. You basically understood, you know, it's
fucking weird. But
I'm looking forward to getting there one day. One day, it's going to happen for me.
So I took this, we had this old board game. I don't know if it was Life or Sorry or whatever. It had one of those wheels on it. You spin the wheel, you know?
Right, yeah.
We don't use it anymore. So I actually took the time, because this is how bored I get.
Yeah.
And I took the wheel and I made it into a sex wheel for me and my wife.
Nice.
I know. It's a good idea, right? And so like on the weekends or evenings where my daughter's spending the night somewhere the next morning, because we never have sex at night. We're too old.
Of course not.
We have it in the morning.
Right, exactly.
When we're charged.
Yeah. Charged, ready to go, and it's quick and easy.
Well, it's always quick and easy. Well, it's always quick. Sometimes it ain't that easy. So we can get up, and then we know she's not here, then we have the run of the house. We can go to any room in the house and go wow.
You mean you could go right here where I'm sitting?
And maybe we have.
It was... trying to get my...
okay.
You know,
that was more of a visual gag.
Right, yeah.
So, and I've got to use this wheel like 4 or 5 times now, probably, since I made it.
Really?
It lands on master bedroom every...
I thought you were going to say it lands on masturbation.
No.
Well, that's...
So that would be almost as
I'll
bad
catch you later. I got to go take care of this.
I'm not sure why I put master bedroom on there.
What
was I thinking?
So every time it's hit master bedroom?
It's hit master bedroom every single time.
Missionary, master bedroom.
You know, yeah. I have to
read. And we'll just watch the regular guy on girl porn before.
I need to redo the board.
Yeah, let's fix that up. I can throw in a few things. Throw in a nice...
No, you can't throw in anything. Make your own damn board.
Can I make your sex wheel for you?
Talk to my wife. If she's down, then I'm still not down.
That might be my calling. It's like, okay, we're gonna put a hot Carl here. You know, we're gonna, you know, we're gonna do a purple fucking headed slime dog, whatever, right here.
So we're going there again.
We're going where? I didn't you know. Maybe some people didn't listen to the after the credits.
No, they all listened.
Part on our last they all episode. Heard
the rusty trombone and okay. the Dutch oven.
So, just yeah. in case. All right.
So, the other day, we're driving in the car, and we're behind some 80-year-old dude who you could barely see his head above the seat back, bald head. And
Canadian,
you know,
license plate?
He's having to reach up to hold the steering wheel. The whole, you know,
the whole
deal.
Whole.
And he's driving
Coachella Valley for
35
you.
Miles an hour with his turn signal on for like 5 miles straight, and I'm behind him. I'm stuck, and I can't get around him, and I'm like, fuck! I finally signal, get up in the other lane, pass him, scream at him as I pass him.
Of
like,
course,
you
yeah.
fucking you dick! Fucking... You know, the old folks home's that fucking way, blah, 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 blah. And about 3 miles down the road, my wife turns to me and goes, you know your turn signal's on, right? And I'm like, fuck!
You're him!
It yeah. The moments in my life that keep coming up to remind me that I'm getting fucking old are becoming more and more frequent.
That was the future and, you. That's all you saw was a glimpse of the future. It wasn't even there.
I know.
She's it's, like, who are you yelling at?
It's really starting to get scary. And I've noticed, too, that because I've become more of a Starbucks whore than I used to be, I've been hitting Starbucks a lot.
Yeah, yeah. Well, they got such good deals there. So.
Well, yeah, $5 coffee. Sign me up. I've got my Starbucks card. I've got my phone app where I just slide my phone. And I'm hooked. But anyways, what I have, and I've heard this is the case, but I didn't know it to be true, but it is, I've seen this from
all,
in my experience inside Starbucks.
Right.
It is totally true. The longer your drink order is, the more of a pretentious fuck you are. It is definitely true. These people that order, and I can't even repeat it, these caffeinated half-calf high chi tea sprinkle of this with a dash of that.
That
with,
sounds about right.
Superheated, but yet ice on top with you know, the swirl and then the dude.
Yeah, yeah. The triple Indy.
Pretentious fucks.
Well, what's cool is now you can put whatever you want on your... People are getting adventurous, I guess, with giving their names when they say, what's your name? So when they call out your order.
Oh, we did it the other day.
We did it, yeah, the other day.
Yeah, and I did Hot Carl.
You did Hot Carl, and it's funny because what I think they just said, we're only going to do Carl or something.
Yeah,
and so they go, Carl, and you get up, and it was... it turned out to be the...
some of the guy
the mailman
Carl.
Or something. Yeah, some of Carl was there. Yeah. The whole idea was to get them to go, Hot Carl! So
they didn't play along.
No, they're no fun over there.
Fuckers. Yeah. All right, well, I think we have geek announcements, do we not?
Yeah, okay, yeah.
I'm going to let you do yours first.
We'll jump right into that. Now, it's once again, we've been plagued. It took us a while to get here, so this may not be...
relevant.
It's relevant.
Timely.
It's still news. I'm sure if you're listening, you probably, you know, I had to dig deep for some of this stuff. So it's, digging deep. So took us a while. We planned on podcasting a week ago.
Smell your finger.
But it does.
Go ahead.
Canada dry Mandarin orange sparkling seltzer water.
And the fresh scent of pine.
So, now, this isn't really huge. Brian McManahan cast as Clayface on TV's Gotham.
That's not huge.
The only reason I say that is because Gotham's basically... It's no wonder Batman can kick all these guys' asses. He's a kid right now. By the time he gets up into his 30s, he's going to be kicking the hell out of... He's going to be beating up 60-year-old men.
Yeah, I've noticed that.
Because they've had, you know, the Penguin and the Riddler and the, you know, Catwoman and... I haven't really been watching it, but, you know, I've been watching from afar, and I've noticed that...
Yeah, that is true.
Yeah, so they're basically just blowing the load with all the villains before Batman's even... You're just like, God, we got a new Clayface now! So, I don't know.
Blowing the load. That's nice.
Slow cooking the beans. Now, this is interesting.
And doing the manga.
This is just a rumor, but 23 Jump Street... is coming out. Why? And it's going to be a crossover with Men in Black.
Which makes me care even less. Men in Black didn't do anything for me.
No. But that's crazy. I think everybody's trying to go for a you know...
Cash grab?
Well, cash grab and a just, you know, a universe where everything is cohesive. You know. Everything's connected. You know what I'm talking about. So, 23 Jump Street, Men in Black. Watch for that, maybe.
Or don't.
Yeah. Mallrats 2. This is what I'm excited about. I was worried because Kevin Smith was doing... He quit talking about Mallrats 2 and he started talking about this Moose Jaws movie.
Well, what happened to Yoga Hosers?
Yoga Hosers is done. It's in the canon and it was at Sundance recently. So it's still coming out. It just didn't have a release date. It's going to be kind of like a... I think it's going to be just in sort of like the independent theater.
So how far down the list is Mallrats 2?
Mallrats 2, okay.
Because he could die of a heart attack.
He very well could, and Stan Lee could die soon, too. He's like,
although, have you noticed on Comic Book Man, he has lost some weight.
He's lost weight, yeah.
He's looking good.
I'm not worried about him dying. If he wants Stan Lee to play a crucial role in Mallrats 2, which he was, you know, he was in Mallrats 1. He wants everybody back. Stan Lee's like in his 90s. He better do something quick, because... Or we're not going to have any hello spider friends. So, but Mallrats 2 shoots in July or August, according to Jason Mewes. So, and Ben Affleck, everyone but Ben Affleck is confirmed. But I have a feeling he pushed this movie back and moved up Moose Jaws. Because I'm sure Ben Affleck is going to be a surprise. He's going to say, oh no, we couldn't get him, but he's going to be in there. He's going to play the guy from Fashionable Male again. Mm. Come on, tell me you wouldn't have popped her. So, Daisy...
I wouldn't have popped it.
Daisy Ridley confirms as Lara Croft. So, Daisy Ridley from Star Wars, The Force Awakens.
Oh, that chick?
Yeah, she's going to be the new Lara Croft.
I can see that.
Yeah,
not that I care.
No, I don't either.
I never cared about Lara Croft.
But... the first time, even when it was Angelina Jolie, I wasn't that excited about it, so...
Don't care.
Now, Stallone... as I said before, is in Guardians of the Galaxy, and apparently somebody saw him in his costume, and it's reminiscent of the Dredd suit that he wore in Judge Dredd. I doubt that's going to be a crossover. I think probably means he's going to be a Nova Corps member. So,
do you know who plays Star-Lord's dad on Guardians of the Galaxy, the cartoon?
Is it Kurt Russell?
No.
Oh. Is it Mark Hamill?
No.
Is it
Shut up.
James
Jonathan,
Spader?
It's Jonathan Frakes.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Red alert!
Jonathan Frakes plays Star-Lord's dad in the cartoon.
In the cartoon of
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Well, that's cool.
Yeah.
Right on.
Just throwing it out there.
I like it. So he's... now, there's speculation that Howard the Duck is going to be back.
Stop it.
In Guardians 2.
Stop it.
Hey, don't shoot the messenger. Just saying. And George Lucas will be producing that scene.
Stop it.
Now, I think I have a Maze Runner 3 star Dylan O'Brien. Have you seen Maze Runners?
No.
Oh. The first one was pretty good. I haven't seen the second one.
I heard they were good.
Yeah. The main character got injured on the Maze Runner 3 set, so that's halting production. So
Push.
Yeah. Terminator 6.
Oh, God.
Right. Paramount says no, but Arnold says, I'm looking forward to it, absolutely. So apparently, I don't know, he hasn't either, I assume if Arnold says yeah, then it's happening. But if Paramount says no, Arnold says it's happening, it's going, it's a go. So, and when Arnold speaks, of course we listen.
Just let Skynet win.
Yeah.
Just so we can be done.
And then there is one more. So you're rooting for Skynet? Is that what you're saying?
If it ends the Terminator stuff, yeah, because I'm kind of done. Yeah. You know, how many spins do you want to put on it?
Well, I mean, sure, they're going to milk it for all it's got. If you know, I didn't think that last one was that bad. Salvation, I thought, was even better than that last one. The one with Christian Bale, I thought it was pretty good.
All right, make me a Terminator movie with no time travel. Ready, go.
That's not possible. We can't even go back to California. So, Riff Trax, this is my last headline. Riff Trax MST3K reunion special in June. So, Riff Trax is going to do a live Riff Trax Live, like they do.
Yeah.
It's going to be an MST3K reunion. Mystery Science Theater 3000 reunion. They're going to have...
Joel and...
Hopefully Joel. I'm hoping.
Well, if they don't have Joel, then what's the fucking point?
Well, they're definitely going to have TV's Frank.
Yeah, but still.
They're going to have a few of the others. So that's look for that in June. I was breaking that to you now. I didn't even tell you that before because we always go to those. So
yeah, I had no idea.
So you're excited.
No,
I can see.
I'm excited if Joel shows up.
I don't know. Yeah. You like that Joel, huh?
I'm gonna make mine kind of quick.
That's what your wife tells me you like to do.
That was so low hanging fruit, dude. Just Walk on by. Don't.
Walk on
be
by.
Be better than that.
I can't. Don't want to.
10 Cloverfield Lane. Saw it. It was decent. But, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, it gets a definite yeah. Now, I know I'm late on this one. Mm-hmm. Everyone else has seen this. I came late to the game on this one. But, man, The Big Short is a good fucking movie.
Is it good?
Have you seen The Big Short?
I haven't, but it's Oscar.
Wow, it was good.
Winner, right?
Fortunately, we have a theater down here where they play movies like 8 months after they've been.
Yeah. Well, especially if they've been Oscar nominated, yeah, they bring forever. Them back.
It'll
they,
be on.
They put them back in. Yeah.
It'll be on Showtime. They'll still be there.
The Palme d'Or and show Swingers and fucking Clerks at midnight and stuff like that. Or used to. Occasionally does.
But yeah, that was really good. And you know what's getting better? Supergirl is starting to grow on me.
Is it?
I've watched like 10 episodes now, and it's actually. I think it's getting pretty good.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I may stick around.
Well, that I will say one thing. I watched Daredevil season 2, most of it, and that's fucking awesome too. So yeah, that's worth checking out.
I heard that. The Ghostbusters trailer, If that's all they got, they need to pack their shit up and go home. The trailer is fucking weak, and if that's the best parts of the movie,
right,
then... Yeah. Don't even ask me to go.
I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
But I am afraid of a
bad movie, and Well, I'm thinking those people, everybody involved, this should be a good movie. Somebody, I think, just didn't know how to cut a trailer. So.
Yeah, maybe. Anyways, free comic book day.
This is a geek announcement. This is a geek announcement.
Free comic book day is coming up. Yep. First Saturday in May. May 7th.
Right.
We're actually doing a live show on Free Comic Book Day.
What?
Say what?
Say what? Give me that stuff, that funk.
Which is kind of an oxymoron. Recording, we're recording a live show.
It's morons.
So I don't know how live
definitely
it is.
Morons involved.
Recorded, but
we're doing a live recorded show. Well, if you come down to Palm Desert, California.
Then you will get to see it live.
Around 11 o'clock.
And you can throw shit. And, yeah.
Come and we'll ask you who your favorite fucking comic people are.
Desert Oasis Comics.
You tell us
where we're doing it.
Yeah,
and Spectrum, which is we talked about Con Man.
Uh huh.
And they couldn't use Firefly
right,
as the actual show.
So
they had to use a fake show.
So they made up
Spectrum.
Right.
Well, they're gonna make a comic book, a fake comic book to go with the fake show.
Right. Right.
And that's going to be a free comic book on Free Comic Book Day Spectrum. So pick that up.
And we're going to be giving away stuff, right? We're going to have trivia.
We're going to have giveaways and trivia and possibly even Full Frontal.
Well, we better. I'm not going to go.
We're going to have
my tour writer.
We're going to have Alex Callego on from Palm Springs Comic Con.
Hey.
And he'll probably even, depending on how ticket sales go, because we're doing a promotion with Desert Oasis.
Shut up, people.
Comic Con.
Yeah.
We're doing a promotion with them for some CG comics out of my collection.
Right, yeah. Yeah.
And if the tickets all sell by then, he'll be picking the winner for that too.
Yeah.
And we're doing that giveaway.
So it's Desert Oasis Comics in Palm Desert, California on May 7th at roughly, we don't know a time right now, but it's roughly 11 o'clock.
Yeah, kind of
a.m.
midday-ish thing.
Yeah. So if you live in fucking Pensacola, Florida, fucking
fly your ass out.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it totally won't be worth it.
Yeah.
Do it anyway. And speaking of the Comic-Cons, we have two now, apparently. Palm Springs Comic-Con, which we are associated with.
Right.
And that's still in November.
And then
Comic-Con Palm Springs, who actually has already booked Stan Lee.
If he lives, as long as he doesn't die.
If he lives to August, he'll be here.
Right, yeah.
So there's that.
I'm going to be in Palm Springs, spider friends. Come on down. It's going to be really hot.
Cash grab. There's a thing in L.A. It's called Weedonopolis, for the Josh Whedon fans.
Right, yeah, yeah.
But I looked at it. I didn't see any names that I recognized, so it might be like a real minor Whedon convention.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's a 3-day thing. It's in LA at the Airtel Plaza.
We love Whedon.
Yeah.
Firefly, Serenity, yeah. The Avengers.
So even if there's no one there might be still cool shit to buy. I don't know.
DC needs to back up a fucking truck of money and go after that guy. Now that he's done with the Avengers, they need to, Zack Snyder knows how to make a fucking spectacle and he knows how to fucking do a movie. I don't know if he really knows how to tell a story. I say fucking, let's get Whedon somewhere. Justice League would be great, but
I think Vladi Dibas would
you
be
think
a good
so?
Director of
right?
Let's get Vladi in there.
I like Bill Walton myself.
That's an inside joke.
Yeah. So Whedonopolis, yeah.
And then on a personal note, Star Wars Battlefront, I've given up. The Empire's won.
Have they?
Yeah, I turned in my fighter and...
Your fighter card? You're done?
My blaster, and I'm... My internet signal is so bad that I just freeze up and they waltz over and just blow my fucking brains out and I'm sick of it. So I moved on. I moved on to Fallout 4, and Fallout 4 is an awesome
fucking
game.
Fucking killer, so fucking...
Killing Raiders.
Star Wars Battlefront, fucking...
Yep.
But, you know, Fallout 4?
It's yep. So that's where I'm at now.
Okay.
Like anybody cares.
Well, yeah. Well, we all want to know what you're playing.
No,
we want to know what you do
don't.
With your time. When you're not spinning that sex wheel, something's got to be going on.
Yeah.
So.
I didn't think that through.
So.
Show info. Right. You do it.
Well, I'll do what I know.
Do what you know. Again, go.
The email is... Email us. Give us some hate mail. Give us something. Give us something. Idle Effect.
Let us know you're alive.
At yahoo.com, correct?
That is correct.
We are on Podbean. You can listen to us on Podbean. You might be listening to us on Podbean right now, which is podbean.idleeffect.com, correct?
No.
Okay.
No.
You might need to take it from here.
Idleeffect.podbean. My voice is giving out. Idleeffect.podbean. Did it again.
Yeah.
idleeffect.podbean.com.
Okay, all right. And then we're on iTunes, which is easy. You can search.
iTunes is just searchable.
These days you can just search iTunes, Idle Effect, we come up. You can search YouTube. We're on YouTube.
Yep, yeah, we have our own channel on YouTube.
Put Idle Effect in there, we come up. Facebook, we're on Idle Effect.
Search it on Facebook.
Search it on Facebook. We're written, you know, bathroom walls.
Yeah. Top drawer.
Find us there, yeah.
Top drawer of some really, really not very nice hotels.
Yeah. Every possible deep, you know, crusty crevice.
Careful, careful.
Underneath them, every barnacle you scrape, there we are. We're in your life. We're so.
And since my wife has deserted us,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to have to work the camera. And so we can.
Well, again.
Again.
Okay.
So we'll do action pose and then you can do whatever.
Then something
crazy
might
thing,
happen, something might not.
Yeah, but I get the feeling it's going to.
Yeah, we're saying goodbye. There won't be anything, so just we're going to say goodbye. And
so whatever you do, don't listen after we do action posts, because
right.
Nothing's coming after that.
Not at all.
Nothing.
Nothing worth listening to, anyway.
That's probably true. 5, 3, and 1.
Yep.
Action pose. I'm grabbing the phone. Hello? Hello?
You know, I didn't tell you, I have a scoop. I have a friend that works for the government. You know how I've been watching this 112263?
Yeah.
Well, it turns out that they've been following up a lead for quite some time, and I got some footage that's going to come out eventually. They call this the Zapruder audio. Now, we've all seen the Zapruder film, but they've been following up this theory that there was definitely a second shooter on the grassy knoll, and that it was... It might have been a very young Randy Macho Man Savage. So, I'm going to play this footage. You're going to hear the first two shots from the school book depository, and then what we think might be from the grassy knoll, and possibly proof of who the second shooter was. Here we go.
Be still my heart.
Ready? Here we go. Here comes the third shot.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I'll just leave it up to you to decide, but...
That was a long fucking road to hoe, dude.
Well, there's also some other footage that it could have been, the second shooter could have been Charles Nelson Reilly. I could play that tape, too.
My God.
And you know, maybe it was, maybe the second shooter was Al Pacino.
I can't in all good conscience sign off on this.
Yes, you can, because you are Mr. Downtown. Thank you, everybody.
I'm out.
Thanks for listening. Jeez.